Hi, hello. Welcome back to Shridhata's Kitchen. My second recipe gonna be very interesting. It's a gobi manchuri. A gobi manchuri with a different blend of a taste called Desi Italian Gobi Manchuri. What makes it special to be a Desi Italian Gobi Manchuri is I'm gonna add a bit of Italian seasonings to give a different taste to it and to be a best recipe to serve for your friends and family. So we're gonna be preparing
gobi manchurian, everyone's favorite gobi manchuri. For this, I have taken butter for sorting it out, and this is the sauce which I'm gonna mix it. I have taken around 5 to 6 spoons of tomato ketchup. I have added 3 to 4 spoons of water. To this, I'm adding 1/4 teaspoon of vinegar and 1/4 teaspoon of soya sauce. To this, I'm gonna add Ajinomoto, or called artificial salt. If you feel this is unhealthy, you can skip. This is just to increase the taste. And for this, we're gonna add 3/4 tablespoon of chili powder. Later you can mix it and blend it nicely. Once all the vegetable is sorted, you can add this sauce for the better taste. And this is a ginger garlic powder for increasing the taste. Today I'll be only using butter, not the oil, for better taste and more yummy. Here I have taken one whole garlic which is finely chopped, and 20% to 30% of the garlic ginger which is finely chopped, 2 medium sized onion finely chopped, and 1 medium sized capsicum finely chopped, and 3 green chilies. So this is the few ingredients. Few more are cauliflower and cabbage for deep frying for the manchurian balls, which I'll be showing you very shortly. For preparing the manchurian balls, I have taken 1 big size cauliflower and 1/2 a medium size cabbage, 1/2 finely chopped. This is to increase the taste and crispiness of the gobi manchurian balls. We're gonna add this. So this one you need to nicely wash it with a salt water, and we need to 1/2 cook it. This one no need to cook, only to add when you're preparing a manchurian balls for the deep fry. This to increase the crispiness. The color has almost changed. It is in the light green color. It is 1/2 cooked now. You can off the gas and start to mix the manchurian balls batter. I have taken already pre-cooked cauliflower. To that I have added finely chopped cabbage and required amount of the salt. And this is all-purpose flour or maida, around 1.5 cup. This is 1/2 a cup of corn flour powder. No need to add any oil or chili powder. You just need to add the required amount of the water and make it a nice gobi manchurian mix so that you can start to deep fry it. In this consistency, you mix the batter. Let the batter get nicely absorbed by all the ingredients. By this time, we will prepare the manchurian sauce. For this, here I have now we're gonna add the finely chopped garlic and ginger. Sort it for a well. Then you can add capsicum, onion, green chilies which you have already finely chopped. Taken Amul butter, which is the best butter. You can also use homemade butter or any other butter of your choice, but I prefer Amul to use. In a medium flame, saute it for 3 to 4 minutes until you get the nice aroma. Preparing a gobi manchuri is very easy. It's just you need to have interest patience and lots of love to cook for your family or anyone whom you are preparing it. See, can you see? You can see the bubbles, so the garlic and the ginger is getting cooked. How colorful it is to look. Now you add all other vegetables to the pan, which is finely chopped onion, capsicum and green chilies. No need to separate and fry it. All together once you can add and nicely mix it up for 3 to 4 minutes till the onion and capsicum is finely cooked, almost 80%. Then we can add the sauces and other ingredients to increase the flavor of the gobi manchurian sauce. Onion and capsicum have almost changed the color. You can see it is getting almost cooked to the 80%. Now reduce the flame, then add the sauce mixture. I've already said you to this, I have taken a tomato ketchup, soya sauce, vinegar and ajinomoto and 1 tablespoon of chili powder. To this you just add a little bit of water and then again add to it. Here I have taken 1/4 teaspoon of garam masala just to increase the taste, and this is onion and garlic powder to increase the taste. If you don't have this, you can skip it. Just mix it and add some more water and cook for 5 to 6 minutes in low flame till the sauce gets completely cooked and even all the vegetables get absorbed the sauce. Then Manchurian sauce will be ready. Oil has started to leak. Now the sauce is ready. You can off the gas. Oil is ready. Now we can add the Manchurian balls. To get the crispy Manchurian balls, we have a technique. We are not supposed to completely cook till golden brown in the one shot. First we need to cook 50%. Then place it on a tissue paper. Once oil is completely absorbed by the tissue paper, again we need to add it to the oil in a very high temperature. Then we need to make it crisp and golden brown. At that time, manchuri gonna be like a restaurant style. Now this is almost 50% cooked. Now we will remove it and place it on a tissue paper. You can see it has almost all the batter is in complete consistency. Now increase the flame. Just wait for another 30 seconds. It should not get golden brown either. If you do like this, also oil will not be absorbed too much. It will be cooked from inside and it will be crispy outside. If you keep it here only till it get completely golden brown, at that time it won't be like restaurant style. Drain all the excess oil, then place it on a tissue paper. Now again put the leftover batter to the oil, reduce the flame to a medium. Two rounds of the manchurian has been half deep fried. Now we gonna add it to the high temperature oil for a crispy texture and till it cooks golden brown. It's almost golden brown in color and also all the bubbles have reduced. Just put the flame into medium. you can transfer it to the tissue paper bowl so that all excess oil will be absorbed and it will be crispy, ready Manchurian balls. Wow, it's completely cooked, it's golden brown and also it is so crispy. So we can start to prepare the manchuri. Sauce is ready, Manchurian balls is ready, and these three ingredients to increase the flavor while eating, I have taken coriander finely chopped and peri peri powder around 3/4 spoon and 1/4 teaspoon of garlic and ginger powder. This is to increase the flavor of our gobi manchuri in a blend of Italian way. So this is a desi Italian gobi manchuri. We're gonna start to prepare it to the Manchurian sauce to get it pretty watery, to mix it all the Manchurian bones. We're gonna add 3/4 cup of the water. Just mix it. Once the water is completely mixed by the thick Manchurian sauce, we gonna add the Manchurian balls to it. Add it fully and mix it up. Butter has started to lean. You can easily observe it's completely shiny in color. Now it has cooked, all the masala has been absorbed by the Manchurian balls. Now you're gonna add peri peri powder, which is available in the market, and this is garlic and ginger powder. This is all a taste enhancing powder. You can skip it if you want, these are the optional. And coriander leaves for the beautiful color and amazing flavor which it gonna release from its leaves. Now you'll just mix it up nicely. It's ready. After you add the coriander, do not cook it for more time. It will start to leave the bitter taste off the gas. Now transfer it to the container. It's ready to serve. My family is waiting to have this yummy gobi manchuri. You can serve with tomato ketchup or chili sauce, or just you can have it all alone. Enjoy everyone. See you all in the next beautiful recipe.